Hi guys. So today I want to talk about all the drama that's going on in Vicki Gunvalson's life of the Real Housewives of Orange County, both on and off camera. Vicki is an OG. Vicki's just a part of the franchise, okay? She's like my grandmother, you know. My grandmother's just someone you used to having around and you try to protect at all times, you know. I used to feel sorry for Vicki, you know, because every single year, she is getting on somebody's shut the hell up, I can't stand you list. And this is a difficult list to make, people, because you just can't shut up. You have to shut up and people still not stand you. It's a hard list to make. But somehow, Vicki manages to make it every single year. I mean, from the very beginning, whether it's Gretchen or Lori, every year she's getting on someone's list. And I used to feel sorry for Vicki. I was like, you know, she seems to be getting on people's I can't stand you list, and she doesn't know why. You know, it just kind of happens. Like, bad things happen to Vicki Gunvalson. Like, you know, that whole Brooks thing, that wasn't in her fault. Like, she had no idea Brooks was a liar. You know, I felt bad. Until I start putting two and two together. Who the hell gets on her castmates, shut the hell up, I can't stand you list every single year? She has to be doing something to get on someone's I can't stand you list every year. She has to be at fault. I mean, this is just too many times. The only problem I have with it is I can't put my finger on what she's doing. Why are so many people not liking Vicki Gunvalson every single year? I really cannot figure it out. Well, all I know is this year will be no exception to the rule. She was back on someone's I can't stand you list. And the victim this year, Kelly Dodd. Now, this is the wrong person's list to get on because Kelly has a hair trigger temper. I like her, but the girl is nuts. The girl is nuts. So we all know that Kelly's gonna be really, really, really pissed off at Vicki for going on a double date with Kelly's ex, Michael. And again, is this intentional or is this just another honest mistake? I don't know. We shall see. So before we see what's going on with that whole storyline, I want you guys to know the drama that happened off camera leading up to the season premiere. Okay, and Vicki's life is just full of drama, people. It's full of drama. So we all know on Mother's Day, she posted on her social media that she missed her family now in North Carolina. That's Brianna and her two children and Brianna's husband. She said, miss you guys. And her son-in-law replied, your grandkids tried to FaceTime you 20 times yesterday. Glad to see you're alive. You're still alive. Okay. She got so upset that she blocked him on her social media. So now that relationship is back on the get out the hell out of my face, I can't stand you list. And yet again, it doesn't make any sense because we all know, if anything else, Vicki's a very good grandmother. She loves those grandchildren. So I don't know what that was about, but somehow she has upset her son-in-law. Then it's this new crazy beef that she has with Jeff Lewis from Flipping Out, okay? Jeff had Kelly on his show, some podcast, talk show, some type of show like this, in which he was talking to Kelly about the upcoming season, and he brought up the name Vicki. He brought up Vicki. Kelly ended up calling Vicki a backstabbing bitch. The following day, a fan tweeted a message to Vicki saying that Jeff was on air calling Vicki fat. Now, I don't know what she did to possess you to be so mean. Everyone knows that's any woman's trigger is when you call them fat. Now, rumors are he said this because he's good friends with Shannon, who doesn't like Vicki, and that he thought she should be fired from the show. It doesn't matter. You don't call a woman fat. So I'm feeling again, Vicki is being a victim. Or did she do something to Jeff to make him this angry? Nevertheless, of course, Vicki had to stand up for herself. So she tweeted him saying that she wasn't fat and she was proud of who she was in so many words. Jeff responded back, saying he didn't call her fat. Then he reworded calling her fat. He said, I didn't call her fat. I just said she wasn't as thin as the other women, and she doesn't dress her age or wears clothes that are flattering. Hello, that's still calling her fat, Jeff. And yet again, she's made another person's shut the hell up, I can't stand you list. What is going on, people? What is going on? I really can't figure it out. I really want to know, is Vicky an intentional pisser offer? Does she intentionally do things to get under people's skin, or is it just something about her personality that rubs people the wrong way? Please let me know in the comments section, because I am thoroughly confused. Also, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and that notification button for more series like these. Until next time, talk to you then. Bye.